that we know resurrection. We're going to turn now to an opening hymn. In your pews, you'll find this thin little black hymn. Let us turn to page 2158. We'll sing Just a Closer Walk with You.
Thank you.
Edson forward for the reading of Scripture. We are now blessed with a time of remembrance. We'll begin with a video remembrance and then have time for people who feel so moved to come forward. Thank you. to me that we might need a moment at this time to wipe our tears. Boy, were you right. I had my own tears to wipe. I know we all do. So let us take a moment to breathe. The Bible readings that we heard from Russ's godsons are full of descriptions about how we need. We need support. And so as we breathe with full hearts, may we breathe in love and care. And as we exhale, may we release some of our sadness and grief. Our full hearts, our memories remain. And so now I'm going to step aside and say that if you feel moved to share a remembrance, you're invited to either place. Please come forward.
Guitars were always brought out, and I just, the music was a big part of his life. And then I came in this morning and saw the wife who sings praise twice, and that really touched me.
Speaking of music, friends, if you turn to the back of your bulletin, you'll find the words for morning has come. Let us sing together.
Praise the Lord.
Now he would say, which maybe isn't your favorite nickname, he would say, St. Marla is such a help to me. And then he would pull me aside and he would say, you know, I know this isn't easy now, Marla. He would say he loves me so much and he knows that it is a lot of work for you. And then he would open up. This man could be as clear as a witness. Ooh, and the lights cut. Yes! The spirit is in this place. He would open up about the love that you two shared and how he knew that your time together and the sacrifices, the work you did, was a gift, part of the gift of love that you two shared. And of course, this is not the only kind of love that he would be clear about. He would haltingly say, you know, I think people might think that I came back to church for Martin. But you know, I have found so much support and love. And it has helped me. But one of the clearest memories, one of the truest to who he is, I believe, moments, came when some of us were sitting here on a Sunday morning and it was about time to vote in November. And so the topic at hand was abortion. Ooh, we know. People don't always agree about that. And so we had an interesting, heated, but lovely conversation. And at some point he said, you know, I just don't think that it's right for my beliefs to determine what happens for someone else. We should listen to women on this topic. Goodness knows I'm not going to get pregnant. He could be silly and he could be light, but boy, was that an example of the way that he could stay in relationship, stay in connection, holding on to who he was and how he was, and creating space, created space for family, for friends, for community. And boy, just as he knew about receiving help, receiving support, I want to say that Rusty helped me. Because see, he was so plain, like a book, like the lights coming on. And he would say, what I'm gonna do this afternoon is. And he would name what was gonna happen about the football game and what would be interesting. How he had set himself up for snacks, what he found enjoyable in it. And his passion, right, snacks, I know, right? It's PG for church. Right, he knew what he loved. We know what he loved. And he would be plain about that, and his interest was contagious. Till a couple months ago, I found myself, since he had started to say he loved old shows like Gunsmoke, the only thing I knew about shows like that were that maybe we wouldn't make TV shows like that in quite the same way today. It was a little bit before my time, but I started watching, right? And sure enough, the energy, the on the edge of your seat, they're trapped in a canyon, what's gonna happen? It was contagious. So my spouse came to me at 11 o'clock at night and said, honey, are we going to bed? And I said, shh, they're trapped in the canyon. And I caught it, right? His interests, his energy, his passions were contagious because he would so clearly, openly share them with people. Once he pulled me aside and he said, Sean, you see me with a walker. You see me with reduced mobility. And that's kept me from doing so many of the things I have done in the past. But he said, who he is, that of music, of celebration. He said, that's still me. Friends, we all need that reminder. Who he is endures. Endures in our memories, endures in our love, endures through God's eternal embrace. We may come to times where in our grief, in our missing and our longing, it may seem like Uncle Rusty is out of grasp. But in our hearts, in our memories, in those experiences we share, oh, he lives with us still. He is living in our hearts, in our minds. He is living in us when we sing those songs, when we rejoice in music, and yes, he is with us when we are on the edge of our seat, wondering what's going to happen in that canyon. And he's with us when we do that characteristic thing he did, which is pull back at some point when it seems to be, and then say, well, this is what I think. I just think this conversation is really interesting. Giving space, right, for other people's feelings, experience, giving space for that connection. He knew how to keep love going. Even when he was in pain, we all know how pain can make us bitter, in less than a pleasant way. And yet he kept love going. Friends, I pray that we keep alive through our memories, through our sharing, through our support of one another, through our knowing that who he is in each of our memories, in each of our experiences, that continues. So I pray, oh eternal God, we give you thanks. We give you thanks for those who are dear to us. We give you thanks especially for Russell, whom you have graciously received into your presence. We pray that you grant all of us here and all who mourn his passing, that you grant your peace. Oh God, let your perpetual light shine upon us. Help us believe in that which we have not seen, so that your presence may guide us through our years, through our days, through our lives. We give you thanks, O God of love, for the gift of joy in days of health and strength, and for the gifts of your abiding presence and promise in days of pain and grief. O God, we know all these things, and we know that you lead us beside still waters. So comfort us. Encourage us. Amen. We have a closing hymn. It's called In the Garden. It is in the red hymnal. It's number 341.
Thank you.
invited for a luncheon. It is in the room behind me. And then at 1 o'clock will be the committal service at the cemetery down the road. But now, my friends, we are reminded that the Lord is my light and salvation. Whom shall we fear? Whom shall we be afraid of when we have God's support and care? And so we pray that the life-giving Spirit of God that first breathed life into you, into Russ, into each of us, may that Spirit uphold you, flow through you, and may God's tender compassion renew your weary spirit and be a safe retreat from fear. May others encourage you in times of loneliness, and may their strength be a resource when things are hard. And above all, may God's deep peace, the one that just doesn't make sense to us, but can arrive with a breath, with a comfort, with a heart. May that deep peace be with you. So with the blessings of God Almighty, of our Creator, our Savior, and the Holy Spirit, may you go in peace and love, now and always. Let us not be shy. Let us gradually move into the room behind us where a lovely luncheon has been prepared.
Thank you.